Never know exactly when it says. It says like going live, but then it, anyway.
Are we or aren't we?
Hello, we think we're live. Hello, everyone. How are you? Stop chatting. Start filming. We're filming. So Adam's here.
Yay!
Adam. And then Moses is right there.
Going to town on his bone.
Yeah, he's enjoying his bone right now. Thank you, Shane. Jeez, that was very generous of you. We haven't even started yet.
I know.
Like, here, take some money.
He's ahead of the power curve.
Yeah. So anyway, this will be, we're thinking we want to do a weekly Thursday night thing where we just talk about cars and stuff. And so we're going to kick it off with this one. I kind of did that in the past and it was fun to do, but admittedly it's hard to do when you've got like just you doing it. So hopefully having both of us will make it a little bit easier. You're going to go work on your van. Awesome. Way to kick off the party. I mean, party's a bit of a stretch for the term. I mean,
I know, I'm still wearing pants. It's not a party yet.
Yeah, true. I am wearing my honorary CNC shirt, Shane, just for you. You know, you like that? Yeah. So, anyway, yeah, it's been a crazy week.
A weird, unique week.
How are your first 4 days of NGSing?
Very weird. I don't know. It's bizarre. I've never been involved in anything like this.
Yeah.
So.
Are you finding it strange that there's basically like no off switch?
Yeah.
That part of it's really weird.
I knew that was going to be a thing though. When we did it, I knew that I was going to be working 24/7. Like I'll wake up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom and I'll check.
Yep, exactly. Yeah.
See if we got first thing I do.
First thing you do when you wake up, you check your phone. You're like, oh, I got to do some stuff.
Yeah.
I'll, like, Mo will want to go out, like, take a pee at, like, 4 a.m. sometimes. Mm. I'll be out there at 4 a.m. literally, like, filing orders and stuff in my, like, boxer shorts in my front yard at 4 a.m. while the dog takes a piss. So it's just a strange existence. It's totally different than most normal jobs.
And now every time I get an email alert, I'm like, oh, that could actually be something I need to look at rather than just spam mail.
So Meg does look a little different.
I look fabulous.
Yeah.
My hair.
Pregnancy curled her hair. She is actually not here tonight. She is over at her mother's house. So I think she was happy to escape. What would be a first supercar for 130K? I mean, F430, Lamborghini Gallardo, you could get a Porsche 997 easily.
Yeah.
For that much.
Yeah.
You could get an Audi R8, although, yeah, if you're going to get the R8, just get a Gallardo.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it's the same
thing.
It
looks better, too.
Looks way better, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I would say those are good options, any of those. Hey, I'm one of the victims of CNC fiasco. Thanks for all that you do. Thank you. Well,
sorry you're having to go.
Sorry, yeah. Sorry that you're dealing with that. It's amazing. Like, it still doesn't end. Like, I still get emails from people, like, every week. It's just, man, it's so sad. How much is the 296 GTB going to be? I just saw those announcements earlier today. I thought they said starting price was like 290. So it's actually more than the F8. So all the rumors that like, oh, hey, Ferrari's building a V6 and it's going to be cheap.
Ferrari and
apparently not. apparently it wasn't their plan. They're like, screw you. We're doing what we want.
How much am I looking at if I have my heart set on a 458?
Where did you say it? Realistically, how much am I looking at if I'm at a 458 in the current market? 175, probably. I think I've seen they're maybe even closer to 200. Like, the current market's crazy. It's just gone up a ton. Hello, GT Pro. What about 60 to 90,000?
Nowadays? Oof. 996 turbo, maybe?
Yeah, 996. Maybe a 997, although it might need some work.
A lower end, like a base 997.
Definitely not
maybe.
Turbo.
Yeah, no, like a 996 turbos are through the roof right now.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, you used to be able, oh, you could get a 360. Yeah, you could possibly get a 355, although then you're going to deal with majors. So, you know, like, those aren't budget cars.
Yeah.
Just because the initial barrier to entry is low doesn't mean that's cheap.
Do you think the initial barrier to entry is low? That means that
something else. Yeah. Yeah, down well, there's a reason why the 355s are worth what they're worth, because everyone knows you're gonna have to put 20K into it every 5 years. So
that's crazy. It's a gorgeous looking car though.
I love them.
I think personally, I think it looks better than the 360. Sorry, not sorry, Stu.
Yeah, I agree. I think the 360 looks dated versus like the 430 looks modern.
Mm-hmm.
It like the 360 is in this weird thing because the 355's got a classic look.
Yeah.
Like it's the wedge with the flip, you know, flip up headlights and stuff. So just it looks that way. Like it just anyway. Do you think the market will drop next year? Good question. If I knew the answer to that, I would be rich.
Yeah. I wish we knew.
I wish we knew. We'd start
making moves.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't look like it's going to. I'm taking the position of I'm not expecting it to, because if it does, then I think there's things that I'll take advantage of, but I'm not expecting it to. I think so much changed because of COVID, and I think people's attitudes changed about what they do with their money. And it's going to take a while for the current market to kind of catch up with the demand. I mean, the demand is just excessive. Anyway, thoughts on new headlight design that Ferrari is heading? I think they're okay. I actually really think the new 296 GTB looks really good.
I haven't seen it yet.
It came out this morning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm not up on the
moment. I didn't know until someone, like, I was scrolling through Facebook, and someone's like, what do you think the new 296? I'm like, Ferrari announced a new car? I'm like, oh, I should watch this.
It's not a good look with the Ferrari expert on YouTube.
Because whatever, like, it's eventually going to, like, I'll eventually learn about it. Yeah. Do you plan to upgrade to Speciale in the future? Probably not. They are too much. And they're kind of a collectible car, and so I would just totally destroy the value.
Stock cars versus lightly modded cars in the market.
Oh,
is there much of a difference anymore now? I think most people are just buying what they can buy, regardless of what it is. It seems like.
Yeah, I mean, lightly modded, I don't think affects Ferraris too much.
I guess it would depend on what the mods are.
Right, like exhausts, wheels.
Nobody's going to care about.
Not so much, yeah.
Because like, it exhausts, everybody wants an exhaust anyway.
Pretty much, yeah. If you start doing body stuff, like if you're doing like wide body kits or slamming the car.
Yeah.
Even like lowering the suspension, you know, like if you lower the suspension, I think that's fine. But, it's once you start doing body work, then it kind of like, then the problem is you need like a specific buyer, right? Like you need the person who wants that car. So,
is it a 3000 GT VR4 or the non VR4?
Oh, good
question. The VR4 is actually an awesome car.
If I like that, Shane. If you think a Ferrari is expensive to work on, wait till you buy a cheap one. Exactly. There's a joke that that Josh used to always tell me, which is whether the Ferrari cost. So, like, let's say you're buying a F430 and whether the F430 costs $80,000 or $130,000, it's going to cost you $130,000. There we go. So, Dan, if I'm looking at $200,000 for an Italia, should I pony up another $50,000 and look at a Portofino? Totally different cars. I wouldn't, because I don't like the front-engine Ferraris. I prefer mid-engine Ferraris. And I think the other thing is, you buy a Portofino, you're going to lose a bunch of money on that car because the values of those don't hold as well. The 458s have already taken the majority of their depreciation. So I think it's, I mean, but if you want a Portofino, it's different. But I mean, they're not even the same like characteristics. So like, you need to go drive those cars and see which one you actually think. Oh, he said NA base model 3000 GT. I don't actually know much about those cars. I know they've gone up a ton.
I don't know a whole lot about them, but I do know that the VR4s are awesome twin turbo.
They're big, heavy beasts.
Oh, too. They're heavy, but I mean, come on, it's a twin turbo. I think it was all wheel drive too.
Yeah, they were.
So, yeah.
Opinion: get a used Gen 2 2017 18 R8 or Gen 1 manual R8 V10.
That's entirely dependent on the person.
V10.
It, and what transmission you want. I would take the manual.
I would take the manual.
Yeah.
I don't. Yeah.
But if you don't want one, then the Gen 2.
And I'll tell you, don't, like, the V8 R8s did not excite me. The V10 R8s were pretty cool. Is the 570 reliable as a first supercar? No.
We don't mean to laugh at that, but I mean, it's a McLaren.
Yeah.
British cars aren't known for their reliability.
No. I mean, there's going to be some McLaren people who see this who are like, well, mine hasn't broken. And I'm going to be like, yet?
Yeah. Now, don't get me wrong. I've driven a 12C before on a track, and
they're cool.
That thing is amazing. Like, I'm not knocking the performance of the car. I personally wouldn't want to own one.
No. There's a reason why I haven't bought a McLaren yet. Part of it's because you can't get parts. Like, you're stuck. If you want to fix the McLaren, you got to go to McLaren. What are your thoughts on government saying they want to get rid of internal combustion engine and the effects it's having on enthusiast-driven vehicle prices?
I don't think it has any effect on it right now.
Yeah, I mean, it's all hearsay so far.
Yeah.
Like, until they pass a law, I don't really care. Or if they start, like, if there's a bill that's in, you know, being voted on, then I'll care. Then I'll call
my... Even if it doesn't pass, it still needs to be shut down.
Yeah, that's when I'll start calling my congressman.
Yeah.
Although, yeah, anyway, we won't get there. Non-VR4... Okay. I really don't know enough about 3000 GTs. cheaper is always more expensive. In a way, in the supercar world, it's kind of true. Like, there's a reason why supercars are cheap. Like, if you're looking at, you know, all things being equal, if you're looking at, like, two different, you know, like, if you're looking at car A or car B and they're both the same basic specs and one's $30,000 less, there's a reason why it's $30,000 less.
Tim's here.
Tim!
Brent, though, what would you look for the ideal car to change over? One with a busted F1 system?
Oh, it's, yeah, I mean, that, like.
Because then you could probably get it cheaper if it has a.
Most likely, system. Yeah. Like, if someone finds one that's got, like, an F1 failure, if they got, like, broken actuators, that's usually expensive enough where people will be like, oh, I don't want to spend $8,000. F1 pumps are kind of cheap, so, like, that's not a big deal. And the accumulators are kind of cheap. But, that, yeah, like, if you're trying to do a 360 manual swap, that, I mean, that's how you get them cheap, is when they have F1 problems. But other than that, I mean, you just buy the one you want. Like, that's, like, I don't know. love the videos of Josh tuning at 40. I wish he worked on AMGs because his shop is closer than Eurocharge. I think he'll work on an AMG. Give him a call. I don't know. I don't think he has anything against AMGs.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess it would probably be if he had the computers for
it. Yeah. I mean, admittedly, like, Eurocharge with AMG stuff, they're kind of
the go-to people.
That's like,
that's what, like, they made their name with.
Right, that's like their bag.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to, like, Josh knows a lot about a lot. But, I mean, if I had an AMG, I'd probably be taking it to Eurocharge.
Adam at Eurocharge is,
like, they
awesome.
They know their shit.
Is there a lot of refinement between 1999
360? Oh.
I think the first model year thing is just bugs being worked out, not so much refinement as much as just reliability bugs.
Yeah, I haven't heard much about the 360s.
Like, even when, like, Toyota makes a new generation Corolla, it's not to be
smart. Yeah, but, like, it's actually, you want to get a good deal on a Ferrari, you buy the first year Ferrari, because the whole myth of, like, oh, the first year Ferraris are always shit.
Is that a myth in the Ferrari world?
I mean, it's possible, but it's, like, So, what, 3 out of 4 of the Ferraris I've owned have been first year?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, no, wait. It was 5 and 9 came out in 2007. Hmm. Yeah. So 3 out of 4. I don't care. Like, they were all cheap. Good.
Trade the AMG and then get a Ferrari, then you can be sure that Josh will work on it.
Hey, there you go.
He works on Porsches too.
He does.
Ask me how I know.
I would go to Josh also if he tunes AMGs. I think he can tune AMG.
There's 69 viewers right now. 60. Nice.
Oh, no, it just fell to 68. Raisin said that. Dang it. Come on. First, I went down another one. No, it's going the wrong way. Now we need 2 of you to sign up. So we can just say, 70.
Oh, man.
It skipped it.
Oh, well. It was there. I saw it.
Nice. Oh, man.
I'm such a child.
Yes, I am too, admittedly. That's why it works well. We're both kind of children. let's see. What else we got going on? So we've got so many things going on.
There's a disaster sitting in the driveway right now.
Yeah, so the video of my new project comes out on Saturday.
This Saturday.
Yeah. So I originally had it scheduled for the F40 tuning to go on Saturday, and I bumped it to Monday because the problem with having a project car or project anything is that someone's going to spill the beans, right? And so I don't like not telling the public soon enough because then someone's going to screw up and then people are going to find out. So I'm like, just get it over with. So Saturday morning, 9 a.m., the new project gets released.
You can laugh at poor financial decisions. I'd just like to point out that I have no financial stake in this. He asked me if I wanted in on it. And normally when he's like, hey, does anybody want to join me in this investment? I'm like, yeah. This time I was like, nope. Not at all.
Mo is right there on the ground. Where are you, Tim? You should be, you can get here in 20 minutes. So then after that project, we also have July 7th or 8th, I forget which. July 7th. I do have beer. July 7th, we're driving to Ohio. So,
and that's the one I think that's the one that everybody will get really
excited. Yes. The car that we're getting in Ohio is, people will like that. Yeah. It's going to be fun. On my way. I think how many beers? Yeah, I got a couple beers. Tim's a show. Love it. Anyone else see the 458 with 120,000 miles on it? They wanted 150,000. Wow. When was this? Was this recently?
You know what, though? Good on him for driving it, though.
No, seriously. That's probably like bulletproof. I mean, it's already, anything that was going to break already broke. When is the kid at 6 going to the 5.9? I wish I knew.
So did I.
Let me tell you, like, that whole kid at 6 thing has been, like, the most stressful thing I've ever done in my life.
I think our parts are stuck in the Suez Canal somewhere.
Probably. It's, like, trying to start a company during COVID that is manufacturing parts and shipping lots of them all over the world.
It's like herding cats.
It's just, and everyone's like, "Why? I don't understand why it's taking you guys so long. It shouldn't be that big of a deal." And blah, blah. It's like, dude,
it didn't take us very long. It took everybody, the people manufacturing it and the shipping people.
Like we literally had parts that just disappeared. That was awesome. Yeah, just like in thin air. It's like we called the manufacturer and they're like, we don't know where it is.
And then they found it like 2 weeks later.
A couple weeks later, they're like, oh, we found it. It's shipping. We're like,
a box just got slipped under a desk somewhere.
I guess so. Like, yeah, anyway.
I did not come from software development. I was in the Air Force for 9 years. I worked on F-15s in the Air Force.
Oh, Tim didn't retire from software development. Tim's not retired.
Oh, yeah. He was in the Navy, though. He was a
true
Excuse us, seaman. But no, I was in the military for 9 years, and then I worked in the insurance business for a couple of years, and now I am making bad life choices with Dan.
I mean, I tried to say you shouldn't do this. I was like, dude, you really don't want to come do this. Like, you know, it took 5 years for me to actually be able to, like, pay myself.
Making me feel good.
Yes. Oh, man. I will say it's been fascinating to, like, do this whole thing, like, all this, like, transitioning over to, like, selling parts and whatever. It's actually pretty cool. Like, it's kind of satisfying to be able to, like, help people get these parts and stuff and like, you know, answer the questions. Because a lot of people, you know, like, are like, oh, is, you know, should I get this? And yeah, absolutely you should. Or no, don't get that. actually, I had a really cool feedback just this week. So a guy ordered an IPE exhaust from us and installed it and wrote this really lengthy email describing his whole installation experience. And it was really interesting because, like, he said, like, the install wasn't that bad, but he was saying that the valve controller that IPE has, and I'm not trying to, like, poo on my manufacturers that I sell, but, like, he's like, it was a pain in the ass to install. And I know from experience, the Forza is, like, stupid easy to install. Like, you could install a Forza in under an hour. So it's one of those things where, like, having customer feedback like that is really cool, because then I can, when people ask me, hey, should I get this IP exhaust and blah, blah, I'll probably be like, hey, probably don't want to get the IPE controller. Not that IPE is bad, but the controller is kind of like, eh, versus Forza is really good. And the Forza controller is actually cheaper. So, like, cheaper, easier. Okay, that's a win. Anyway, I think I can really, on a much smaller scale, on the supply changes. Yeah, as I have started something smaller out of necessity for my own car, headlight upgrades. Everything is slow, let me tell you. The number of emails we get from people asking, hey, do you have a status update, is like every week we get at least 3 or 4, I'm going to say. And I feel bad because it's like, there's nothing we can do. Like, you know, and I asked the manufacturers, hey, any update on this? And like, nope. And I'm like, okay, no updates.
Yeah.
But it's just everyone.
It's frustrating for us too, though.
Yeah, believe me.
We want to get you guys your parts.
Yeah, exactly.
We don't take joy in you guys not having your stuff.
Every time I see one of those emails come in, hey, can you give me an update on it? I'm like, oh, man. I just feel bad because I'm like, all right, I'm going to email my manufacturer 5-6 hours later and get back to me and be like, no updates, or, oh, it's being delayed, or, you know, another month. I don't know. So it's just frustrating. Any updates on the Garage Queen? Yes. We are really close. So funny thing about that, so when I got involved with those guys, with my software background, and they were like, hey, we're going to kick this thing off in like a month. And I'm like, no, you won't. They're like, yeah, we'll have this in a month. I'm like, no, you won't. It's software. I know you won't. Anyway, so no, it's not ready, but very close. They've been working on it. So like, my position is not actually writing any of the software. So, you know, anyway, yeah, we hope to have it out within 1 to 2 weeks. That is the hope. We'll see if it happens. Carrie said, look at the hair on that guy.
You're just jealous of my hair, Carrie. That's what that is.
It can house a small family of pigeons.
It can house a large family of pigeons. Let's be real here.
Gabe, so Adam, have you been working from Dan's couch all day or what? Where's HQ? HQ's wherever we want it.
Yeah. No, I got here not too long ago for this. We, you know, we can webcam chat throughout the day, have official meetings and stuff.
That was official meetings, yeah. We're so official. Let's see. If he had a katana, it would have gone faster. True. Any upcoming Ferrari events? There was something. I can't remember now. The problem is I've got, like, a lot of distractions going on with a pregnant wife, and then my family's coming to town next week, so I'm, like, haven't been paying super close attention to everything going on in the car world. There was, like, some FCA events locally, so if you're in Austin, there's some FCA events, but outside of Austin, I haven't been paying too much attention. I gave that guy $20 to shave the mop in his head. I'll give that guy $20.
You would hate it if I got rid of this. This is epic right here. And the stash is coming back.
I encourage the stash.
I'm no longer shaving the stash. I'm shaving all of this, but the stash is...
You need to be Ron Jeremy.
Yes.
Finally, someone mentioned the hair. Nice. COVID cut.
Thanks, Carrie. Appreciate it.
Well, that was Shane.
No, Carrie said the next one.
Oh, hello from St. John. You're watching there? Even willing to burn vacation time to watch Adam's career crash and burn?
Right here, Carrie. You're right here in my heart.
Yep. Just so everyone knows, Dan was extremely helpful with me when I ordered parts for my AMG GT. Yes, thank you. I had a ton of questions and he took the time to answer. Thanks again, Dan.
You are welcome. That was cool because that was like the first time I sold anyone parts for an AMG GT. And it was funny. It's like, now I'm like, yeah, we need AMG GT parts. So we're going to start trying to get some on the website. Hair, bring back the stash. Yeah, we're going to.
Yeah.
Have you checked out the new Porsche dealers? No.
I have. It's awesome.
And have you?
Oh, yeah.
I think we need to talk to them. We need to see if they'll, like, give us loaners.
That would be awesome.
I mean, it's right up the street.
Yeah. What did you do on F50s? I was a crew chief. So mechanics, hydraulics, some engines, not really anything avionics related, just general maintenance, engines, hydraulics, stuff like that.
Sorry. Beer.
Send Meg our regards. Thank you. Yes, she'll get that. In Italian accent, buongiorno, Adam. Huh? You know, call. You know, like a bust of the corn in the cox. What?
What does that mean?
What is that supposed to mean? Any planned track days coming up? No, I don't have any on the radar.
So I'm a member at Harris Hill and down in San Marcos, so I can do a track day whenever I want. But right now, it is way too hot for
that. Dude, nonsense. This is like the hottest.
Yes.
Ever. And it's not like temperature hot. Like, it's just hot. Like,
and the humidity.
The humidity. It's like 90. It'll be like 95 out, but the humidity will be well over 50%. And you just go outside and you just instantly sweat. Like, I changed my clothes 4 times today and I took 2.5 showers. Ask me how I took a half.
Let's not. How much for Adam to rock a mullet? So my wife actually wants me to rock a mullet. So
I encourage this.
That's actually in the cards.
Let's do it.
It may happen. So the problem is my hair is kind of curly, and I'm afraid that it won't extend.
Oh, yeah. It won't be like mullet. Yeah. It'll just turn into like
and a... So that's – I kind of want to grow it out a little bit more so that I get – I was at ATV today, and I saw a dude with a killer mullet because his hair was straight. I mean, it went down to, like, his shoulder blades.
To do, like, a proper, like, Kentucky mullet, it has to be, like, razor straight.
I just think it has to be long enough.
Yeah,
but so that people know what it is. Yeah. Yeah.
Did you guys ever talk about the 296 GTP yet? Just briefly, did they miss an opportunity not calling it a Dino? Potentially. The only thing about it is it's like, it's got better performance than, I think it's equivalent performance to the F8. So, like, the whole Dino thing was like, it was supposed to be like the cheaper alternative Ferrari, but I mean, I don't know, they could have, but people are gonna buy it either way. Porsche.
I do need to listen to that voicemail you left. I saw that it came through, but I was doing something. I was still working my old job when that voicemail came through. I haven't listened to it yet. Somebody left a voice message on the Ferrari. The voicemail for it. I'll have to go back and listen to.
That was a part of it. Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry.
It'll look great when you're cross-examining somebody in court.
Oh, man.
Hopefully the Texas lawyer doesn't have to come back out now that I'm involved.
Yeah. Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Like, I went from having zero legal problems to lots of legal problems this year. Just like, what the hell? Stu Dog! Wait, oh, hey, there's Stu. I didn't even see that. I mean, shave your head, bro. I'm working. Yeah, I got that down. That's right. Sup all. Also, what do you think of the recent design language, F right? Assets look nice. But did they make a mistake in dropping Pininfarina? Maybe. I mean, I think their first, like the 488 was the first one without Pininfarina, right? And it was kind of a miss, but I think the F8 looks good. I think that the new 296 looks good. So I don't know. I don't know if they really screwed up losing Pininfarina. Let's see. There's an F1 viewing party at COTA on Sunday, followed by parade laps behind the pace car. Any interest? When is that?
Sunday. They're in, where? They were in France last weekend. I watch every F1 race. I can't remember where the hell they're at this weekend.
I hear Tim.
Oh, he really is coming.
He is, yeah. I'm going to unlock the door.
I kind of thought he was kidding.
Nope. Front door unlocked. Come on, work. Is it going to work? I love TikTok.
Oh, yeah, there. I'm back.
Cool. All right. Hey, guys. Enjoy what you do on the channel. Watching from Newcastle, Australia. What time is it there?
Yeah, it's like tomorrow. It's probably tomorrow, noon like, or no. 1 o'clock tomorrow there. Yeah, they're like 19 hours ahead of us or something crazy like that.
Oh, well, tell us what time it is. How about the new Berlina LM tribute?
The what?
Which one was that? I didn't see that. Have we started playing next year's devaluation tour yet? No, I got to get this one first. Which reminds me, thank you for bringing that up.
Austria,
I need
that's right.
Five more people.
Friday, 11:30. I was close.
It's 11. Wow, you're right. It's almost noon. Okay. All right. Yeah, you're cool. Yeah, I need five more people on the devaluation tour of Colorado this year. So we need people to sign up because, if I don't get at least probably five, but it's certainly like three more, I'm going to lose a lot of money, and then I'm not going to do it again. So I've already had to shell out many tens of thousands. Come in, Tim!
It's open!
It's open!
I thought you were kidding. I didn't think you were actually going to come.
Sure he is. He lives pretty close.
No, I know, but still.
There you go. Carrie, devaluation tour is the best thing I've done. Mercy, it was unbelievable. I agree. Anybody that is able to go, please do it. Yes. Take it from Carrie. It was epic. Where's our Lord and Savior, Mo?
Well, he's down greeting Tim right now.
Yeah, he's saying hi to Tim.
I watch all the F1 races.
He does. You're more into F1 than I am.
Tim! I have a new project.
You can't say anything. Don't say anything.
Nope. Badass, though.
Thank you. It's the best, worst decision of my life.
Well, hi, Mo.
Yeah, I'll scoot over a little. Mo.
People just show up to the live stream now.
Yeah, I know. People just show up. Let's see. What else we got? Hope NASCAR returns. I actually heard that was a really good race.
It was awesome.
The weather sucked.
But what's great.
Yeah.
It's funny watching those big, heavy cars lumber around a Formula One track.
Yeah, I'd like to see them run in the drive, because if they were anything like the V8 supercars that first year.
That was the best. I still think that was... Hey! No barking. That still was the best race I've ever seen at COTA. Because it was like bumper cars.
Bumper cars with good racing.
Yes.
I've heard like if they wreck each other, they get out and like hit each other with their helmets.
No!
They're angry no Australians.
And plus a bunch of Aussies came and sat with us, and they were on like a 3-month tour of the U.S.
Were we there together?
Mm-mm. I was over in my seats in 15.
I was in 15. We talked to a bunch of Aussies. I wonder if...
I don't know.
Well, there's a lot of Aussies that came.
But, oh my God. We were so drunk, and it was so hot that weekend.
Yes, it was.
Oh, my God. We would drink, like, two waters and then a six-pack. And, you know, it was a pain in the ass because there weren't enough beer vendors walking around.
Yeah.
And so we would take turns running down there and just come back with these huge bags full of beer and just hand them out.
That's like, this is $500 in beer.
We were shit-faced.
COTA doesn't do open track days, but you can sign up with, like, Chin Motorsports and Edge Addicts. And yep. There might be one or two other ones that do it.
Coming up this weekend for Chin.
Yeah. Ben
Someone asked, Ben asked me to go on the Supercar Devaluation Tour this week. I will consider it, but only if we stay at the castle. We are staying at the castle.
The castle is awesome.
So, originally, I didn't schedule the castle because I was going to make it 15 slots, because the castle only has 10 rooms. So, you only get 10 spots.
Unless you know each other real well.
Yeah. So, I decided, you know what? I don't want
Ben and Chris.
I don't want to deal with that many people, so...
They spooned.
Yeah, you're right. So, yes, we are back at the castle. I also was like... not sure if they wanted us back. Admittedly, when I called them and told them, I was like, they were like, so we need to discuss this.
Really?
Yeah.
They didn't appreciate all the nefarious activities.
There was a couple of things that may have happened. Anyway. We'll talk about that.
See, come to Colorado for the trip. You get to engage in nefarious activities.
But please don't ruin it at the castle.
Just not at the castle.
Yeah,
there's activities.
Don't do it at the castle. Don't ruin that one, because that one's, like, irreplaceable.
Yeah, it's
make that a recovery night.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Unfortunately,
ironically, that was the worst night for all of that.
Oh yeah,
that was,
dude. We got
hands down the
snow,
worst one.
Dude. Well, it's because they had, like, the wine bottles.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
There and were expensive wine bottles.
There was a wine bottle in every single room. Plus, they had a drawer full of them. They said, "Oh yeah, help yourselves." I don't think they realized that we, like, were stupid and drank
stupid.
We drank all of the bottles out of every single room, plus cleaned out the drawer.
Oh my God.
It was like, I'm not even kidding. I think we had like 16 or 17 bottles of wine.
I don't know how Ben drove the next day. Ben
oh, yeah.
Chris drove the
Too bad he's
day.
Not on this. That would have been funny.
Yeah.
Anyway, the castle stay was fantastic. And the wash boy was got to become a man. We're not supposed to talk about that.
Oh man! Is he gonna be the car guy this time?
What? Oh, yeah. He's so far still the wash guy. Yeah, I gotta call and confirm.
And we can't call you the sag wagon driver either. You have to have a nice.
No.
Like the signore, like for a cycling team.
Oh, yeah. There's gotta be a term, like, in Italian that's like, yeah.
Mo,
no.
Stop it.
No, what? Here, go. He wants his bone.
The director sportif or something.
Yeah, director sportif. That's cycling.
I'll wear a chauffeur's cap if you guys get me a chauffeur's cap.
Done. Consider that done. By the way, like, someone's at the door. Hello? Oh, hi, Porter.
I'm
gonna let her. Oh, here, I'll just unlock it.
Oh.
Who is that?
It's Porter, my neighbor. He's here to walk Mo.
Oh.
Our neighbor walks our dog.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Mo, you lucky dude.
Mo, go downstairs. Go get a walk.
How can walk to go all by itself?
I told it to unlock.
Had a fire in their Genesis coupe. What?
What? Hold on, Dan, I'm buying one of those fire extinguishers for you after I read someone at their Genesis coupe a few years ago, and not knowing why, legit made me nervous. They had a fire. Oh.
My wife drives a Genesis coupe.
Any car can catch on fire, man. I mean, even reliable cars can catch on fire when something goes wrong. A buddy of mine had a Jeep Grand Cherokee catch on fire because it, like, lost oil pressure and, like, blew the engine. Jeez, and then the engine spilt all of its oil and fuel all over the headers and immediately burst into flames.
Holy.
Like, he was like, shit, get out! You
know? I caught my 71 Super Beetle on fire.
A Super Beetle?
A couple times.
A couple times?
Wait a minute. More than once?
Yeah, so the first time I'd installed a stereo and you had to run the wires to the back on it. And what? one of them had come out from under the floor mats. And so when I moved my seat, it pinched the wires and shorted. Ooh. And instantly the whole interior of the car filled with smoke. And so I, you know, you smell it. So I I figured that had to be it. So I just grabbed the radio and ripped it out of the dash. Solved the problem. The second time I was late coming back from a deer hunting trip, my brother and I hit 109.
In a
71 Super.
You got balls.
And I ended up melting the freaking exhaust off. So we're going down the highway, just flying downhill, of course. All of a sudden, and so one side had melted off, you know, one bank. And so we just went out and jumped up and down and broke the other side, threw it in the back seat, and sounded like freaking.
It's a shame there weren't cell phone cameras back then.
I know, right?
To record all of that stuff.
Admittedly. Yeah. Everyone only knows really about my F430 that caught fire. I've had two cars catch fire, though. Yeah. The other one was my fault, though. I'll talk about it another day.
What's the update on Tim's 348? Well, he drove it here.
He drove it.
Yeah, 348's doing well. No air conditioning, but I've got a leak in the system. So. But other than that, yeah, it's doing great.
That sucks.
I've twice tried to send money to the Mo Treat Fund. Has it gone through? I mean,
is there a Mo Treat
Fund? I don't know. I'm not sure what thing you're talking about, but I mean, we do get occasional like donations and stuff. Rachel, are you monitoring this chat activity? I don't see Rachel on here tonight. I don't know if she's on.
Carrie.
Why don't you be a little bit more subtle about that, Carrie?
Is the additional drive tank event, you know what, video any closer to getting approval? I need to text and ask.
I would like to know the update on that.
Yeah, I do too. I want to release that video. Bad. There's a video I've been sitting on that I can't release as a courtesy to the people who are involved in it. That's the difference between like me and other YouTubers, I guess, right? Like other YouTubers would have been like, screw it, we're going, we'll do it live. You know, like I'm
a little integrity.
I have a little bit of integrity. And when people are involved in videos and say, hey, I prefer you not to show that video, I respect that. Even if it is a video that probably would get a million views.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can imagine we had an incident.
A view per dollar?
Oh, I would finally be able to recover money off that trip. Because that trip was a total financial loss.
But it was fun.
Oh, God, yeah. Any plans? Northeast road trip. How far northeast? We talked about doing like Tennessee,
North Carolina,
Tail of Dragon, that sort of stuff. I think that's certainly something to consider.
Go and pose on Jim or on James.
Yeah, we could go James. Crash it. That's what we should do. And we should make 20 people just go stay at his house.
Dude, he's got a huge place now. So.
Oh my God, I love his
new bigger than the place that was one.
Dude,
yes.
In a state now.
Yeah. Yeah. Dude.
Yeah. Well, so James and Melissa, if you're listening, we're on the way.
Where is Meg? She is at her mother's house.
Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. My mom will be here tomorrow.
I know.
Oh! She's over at Tim's place right now.
Well done. I walked right into that. Jeez. They're actually in Fredericksburg right now. They drove all the way from Phoenix.
And they stopped in Fredericksburg rather than driving the rest of the way here? Well, or I guess they were getting
the whole family's coming for a week.
Oh, wow.
Like
your brother?
My brother isn't coming. He couldn't make it. But my two sisters. So my sister Laura, we haven't seen him. Well, I haven't seen her in, I'm going to say, 2 or 3 years.
Wow.
Maybe three. I think it's been three. Yeah. So I don't get to see my sisters. It was Laura, I don't get to see very often. Christina, I see more often because she's in the Chicago area. But Laura was living in Qatar.
Oh, yeah. It's just right next door.
Yeah. It's a mirror.
Why would she live in such a godforsaken place?
Because her husband works for oil companies.
Had to be military or oil.
Yeah, pretty much it. I want to go visit, but I don't want to live there.
You should go with, like, meet him in UAE or something.
No, I'm go to Qatar.
Well, yeah, go there too, but don't stay long.
No.
I had my appendix removed in the UAE.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You told me that story.
Nice hospitals.
Come to North Carolina in the Tail of Dragon. I have a huge house you could meet at up at Little Switzerland. I never heard of that. Pool, foosball, fire pits, giant deck. You could also do the Diamondback.
I've never heard of the Diamondback.
I never heard of that, but that sounds interesting. I mean, that all sounds great. You and Meg fighting, say you kicked her out? Yeah, right.
If that happened, Dan would be the one to get
Yeah, give me
out.
A break.
Dan would be calling, you Adam, know. I need to come stay in your
guest room. Pregnant wife?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's not going anyplace.
Give me a break. If there was a fight, I'm definitely...
Pregnant gonna... or not, you know that Dan would be the one that gets kicked out.
Pretty much. It's pretty solid.
Mo would be in bed.
Yeah.
She even kept the dog.
Yeah. No kidding.
Diamondback is much more challenging. Is that because there's more traffic or because it's a better road? I've never been to the Tail of the Dragon. It just seems kind of touristy to me.
It is.
I actually went there on my retirement motorcycle trip with my brother. Yeah. It ended up being a disaster of a trip.
Yeah.
But we actually found some roads that are better than the Dragon. They were just perfect, absolutely perfect pavement. Like it was laid down that day. It was so smooth and
there's
just gorgeous.
I'm trying to remember where it is. So it's a little bit northwest of Asheville. There was this road. So it's not the Tail of Dragon, but I think they call it the Rattler. And it was like more than twice as many turns as the Tail of Dragon. And it was like, because I did it when we went out to the FCA Broadmoor event, or Biltmore.
At the castle.
Yeah, the castle. Well. Castle-ish.
The palatial estate.
Giant-ass place. Yeah, there you go. Where's Tim's beer? I don't know. He can go grab one himself.
Yeah, anybody need a refill?
I'm good.
I'll take another.
You don't have one.
I don't,
what do you mean
I
you're
have
good?
To drive home.
So do I.
I would like to drive the Tail of the Dragon just because, I mean, it is a
cool exactly. Because it's, well, it's so well-known.
I just there's so many motorcycles and everything else. I'd be worried about somebody coming into my lane, and that would be a disaster.
Any names picked out for the kids? Kids, plural, singular.
Do you know something named?
Oh, he corrected himself. Kid. There you go. I was like, yes, we already have the child's name. It was we actually knew it before he was even conceived. We kind of said, if we have a kid, this is the name we want, and then we did. So the way we did it, because like, you ever see like those videos or hear about these people who like find a name they really like? Oh, it's in the middle drawer. Okay. There's all these people who like are trying to find a name for a kid, and they ask people, "Hey, what do you think of this name?" And then people like
bash it.
Yeah, they're like, "Oh, that's a stupid name." Which that's a crappy thing to do. But people do that.
How long ago did y'all pick the name?
Before he was even conceived, like 10
well, I mean,
years
like
ago.
How long?
Oh, Meg's been tossing around this name for probably 2 years.
Well, Enzo's still on the list then.
this name's in stuff, dude. It's a bad. So anyway, if you didn't know, I guess I can say the name, whatever. Not that many people are watching.
You want to clear that with Meg first?
Nah, I mean, like people are gonna find out his name. It's not like it's a secret. It's just we didn't want to like we don't want. Our child to be like a star of the channel. Like it's not the point of the channel. Like I'm not going to use my kid as a prop. Right.
Until we start Normal Guy Super Baby.
Well, of course.
Or we found out how much that little guy can bring.
Part of it is if you have like a underage kid on YouTube,
they're really weird.
They're
about that.
Yeah. It's messed up. Ooh. So anyway, so his name is Anderson Sebastian Hurlburt. So his initials are A-S-H. So I'm going to call him Ash because Army of Darkness. That's right.
That's awesome.
Name's Ash. House first. And then Meg wants to call him Sebastian. So we're probably going to use those two most commonly. We don't want to call him Seb. She doesn't like that. But and no, it had nothing to do with
Sebastian Vettel. Literally had nothing to do with it. But Meg's parents obviously want to call him Anderson. So there you go.
A little glimpse into Dan's life tonight.
Yes. Late to streams, thoughts on the new 296. Sorry if you already talked about it. Ooh. We did already talk about it. I like it.
I do too.
I guess I need to take a look at this and see what
it looks like. I want to see the performance numbers. If it's gonna it's gonna be faster than the SF90.
0-60 and 2.9. Well, they said 0-100, but they didn't say if it was kilometers or miles an hour. I'm assuming they
probably kilometers.
Kilometers.
Yeah. So for 2.9, yeah. Because that thing isn't gonna do 0-100 miles an hour.
Well, 2.9. Right. I was like,
if it does, I'm selling the house and the dog.
Yeah, I know, right? I'm buying one of
those. A kitten.
This thing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it looks good. Normal baby supercar. Middle name is Sebastian. Ash, yes. Shop smart. Shop S-smart. You got that? I love that movie.
I like that exhaust.
A weird exhaust. It looks cool. The front looks like a fourth-gen Camaro. The rear quarter panel looks like a Ford GT.
No.
No, it doesn't.
I like the rear window. They brought back the old Dino style with it.
Yeah, I like. Yeah, I do like.
Which kind of, you know, harkens back to the only other V6.
GT Pro. I wish I could jump on one of these tours or drives. I'm sore bored of the roads here in NorCal Bay Area. If you want to drive further and further out, soon I'll have taken all the routes here. Haha. Join us. I mean, there's still 5 slots. You know, you can. September, what? September
26th,
I think.
I have it on my calendar.
I think it's September 26th through October 2nd.
So, I guess GT Pro, you'll have to join us and go up to Oregon next year.
What?
For the FCA annual.
Oh.
Not that I really want to go to Portland.
I don't want to go to Oregon.
Why would you want to go to Portland?
Exactly. Why would I want to go to Portland?
It's a hell of a drive.
It's, I mean, the area surrounding Portland is beautiful. Gorgeous.
Oh, yeah. When I lived in Idaho, I did all those roads up there. Dude, those are some of the best roads in the world. I've never driven the Tail of the Dragon, but I bet you some of the roads up in the Pacific Northwest rival the roads in that area.
There's a great
Maybe route. Not that particular road, but.
There's a great road that goes around Rainier.
Oh, is there?
I did that one time, and it was phenomenal.
Hmm.
And then, you know, there's a bunch of them up around like Leavenworth and, you know, that whole area, just east, northeast of Seattle.
But come on, Colorado is.
Oh, yeah.
That's the problem. Like, so, like, well, I guess the North Carolina, Tail of the Dragon, those sorts of things, it's kind of a different drive than the Rockies. Because, like, the Rockies, you had some switchbacks and whatever. It wasn't really about, like, just hauling ass, but it was so beautiful. You know, like, the roads were just...
It's just so much bigger there.
Yeah, it's grander.
Yeah. Because, I mean, like, in Carolina, up in that area, there's so many pine trees you can't see.
Yeah, you can't see crap.
When you're down in, like, a tunnel, which is very cool.
Yeah.
But, and it's beautiful when you do get a glimpse across the valley. But, yeah, it's not like Colorado where you look out, you know, and see 400 miles.
Yeah.
I've been all over the world. I've been in tons of different countries. Well, you know, you've done the same thing in the military, but Colorado was some of the most beautiful places. Like, when you see some of the drives that, like, everybody compares, oh, I wish America had roads like they did on Top Gear or whatever when they went across
Europe. They're in Colorado.
Yeah. This was
looks a lot like Switzerland in places.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't do as many of, like, the crazy switchback roads like they do in some of Europe, but they do have switchbacks, and
that's because the Rockies, I mean, most places aren't as steep as the Alps.
Yeah, yeah.
So you don't have to.
Or the Pyrenees or something. Yeah. Yeah. Do you not have any time anymore for rallies once the kid comes? I mean, sure I will. Just not. I mean, I'm only doing, well, crap, with COVID, I haven't done a rally in probably over a year. It's been over a year.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm just going to have to buy a Luso so he can go with.
You can come in a 458.
Yeah, where are you going to put Meg? Well, Meg doesn't care. She'll be like, take the baby, give me a week off.
Yeah, exactly. She doesn't want to deal with that. Are you kidding me? That I could possibly do. Thanks, Tim. Oregon border, I think, is maybe 8-hour drive for me. Yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad at all.
God, 8 hours doesn't even get us out of Texas.
Nope. Well, not if you go west, it doesn't.
Definitely not west.
There are hardly any pine trees in West North Carolina and East Tennessee. Tim may be confusing balsam for pine trees in upper elevations.
Maybe, yeah. They look like conifers, whatever.
I lived in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Oh, there's a reason they call that place Vietnam.
Curious and valid point. The tail of dragon is way too slow and tight to enjoy like Colorado mountains we did. Yep. Yeah, it's like
those the
you're
30-40.
Yeah, 30-40 for the North Carolina, Tennessee, that stuff. Rockies,
140.
Well, I was saying on the mountains you're doing like 70, 80, 90.
But when you're looking at a cliff
with no guardrail.
Is that the $1 million highway?
Yeah, the $1 million
like
highway.
20 miles an hour, and we're like,
yeah, you're white knuckle, like, oh god, don't screw up. But that was
so... like climbing Pike's Peak too.
That's pretty cool.
That's a fun drive.
And I tell you, the other cool thing is you get up so high, you feel the car not perform as well.
Yeah, and the temperature gauge steadily goes
it's
up.
It's not a fan. Yeah, it's crazy. Like you,
especially if you get something like the 348 that's already underpowered, sitting there flogging it.
Come on, baby,
giddy up!
Oh man!
But hey, I remember when I was a kid, we'd go to Colorado every summer, and you'd be climbing up some of those mountains, and there'd be somebody in a freaking 1970 Volkswagen bus. You know, that they overheat and steep,
no.
You know,
could it even doing like go 10 miles up the hill?
Oh, that was, yeah, it was ridiculous.
I visualized 296 GTP headlights like that of a Dino and 250 GTO. Looks cool. We'll render in Photoshop and post soon. The rear fender design is spot on.
Cool. There you go. Hey, the next normal guy supercar project, once the 296 comes out, make a front end with a GTO or 250 headlights.
On one of those?
Yeah, put a body kit on it.
Yeah, let
badass.
Me just pull out the wallet that I don't have.
Yeah.
Hey, all you need is one prototype, you know? Get a mold.
You want to drive the Cherokee.
I've heard of that.
Skyway.
I've been there.
Back if the Dragon, Diamondback, the Snake, you ever in the PA area, I can show you some good stuff. And then, man, NKRT at North, I think, central area of the state. Here's something on bat today, a 2009 F430 gated with 36,000 in prior damage, sold for $245. Oh, I saw that.
Sold for what?
$245?
Why?
Because the market's retarded. The market makes no sense right now. Sorry for using that word, but... the market makes no sense right now. It doesn't.
Yeah.
Jeez,
that
man.
Car is not worth that much. I'm
so
sorry.
So your next project.
Thank you, Billy.
With the current market, you ought to do quite well on that. Not the project in the driveway, the one after that.
Oh, you know about that one?
Yeah, you told me about it last weekend. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll do fine on that one.
Yeah.
I think
people will love that.
I'm excited about that.
Dude, I'm excited.
Yes. I can't wait to get to Ohio.
Yeah.
Dude, we're going to have a hard time not driving. Like, you know how crappy the gas mileage would be because we're driving like 90 with the trailer?
Get home.
Like, hey, look, I got 6 miles per gallon.
Are you taking your truck or Adam's?
His.
Mine's like a Cadillac. No offense.
I have the lower trim.
Hey,
I mean,
you gotta pay Dan back and fart in it in the first block.
Yeah. You think I won't be armed?
Taco Bell before you leave.
Love the work on the 911 Turbo recently.
Yeah. Hopefully there will be more coming. Not maintenance or anything like that, but we have some ideas. Hopefully something will work out.
I turn it into a Ferrari.
I'm ugly, not stupid.
Oh, I will go with Carrie from Stu on a drive anywhere. Put both Ferraris in your car. Holler, Carrie. Grease me up, Carrie. That's because Carrie's your savior.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah.
People are spending their otherwise holiday vacation money in cars. That's right. We'll hammer down Dragon trailer. 360 manual, please. Maybe at some point. Oh, sounds like Porter's back with the dog. I need to unlock it. Oh, he's got a code. Whatever. Anyway, probably wrap this up in another minute or two. So it's been almost an hour.
Yep.
So, got any last questions? Do the last round.
Get them in now.
Yeah, and get your questions
last
in.
Last call.
Last call. We're trying to like keep it to only an hour because I know Megan and I used to do like an hour and a half, but that just made me
two bottles of wine. Take a minute.
That's true. I don't know if I ever drink two. Maybe like one and a quarter. Momo. Come here, Mo.
Hey, Mo, come say hi to your fans.
Here he comes.
He actually has more fans than all three of us combined.
I know, right? Well, he's better looking.
Oh, here he is.
Momo! What's up, buddy? Here, jump up here so I can see you.
Will this be a weekly thing?
You already hit me in the
yes.
plums.
Yes, that is the hope. We're going to try and make this
every
week.
Thursday.
At least we'll try it for a while, and if it's too much, then maybe we'll do like every other week.
Well, also, I think we're talking about web chatting,
yeah,
so that
yeah.
I don't have to drive all the way out here. So.
Yeah. What year is my forfeit? Is it 2010? Since it's going to be more Porsche-related videos, do you think you need to change the name of the channel to Normal Guy Sports Car?
That hurts.
Well, someday you'll have a GT3 and you can join the crew.
I'm pretty sure that in its day, the turbo kept up or was faster than the Ferraris of its day.
Oh, I'm sure it was.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's not a
slouch at all.
But it's like the Corvette argument. They're just as fast. It's a quantity thing to me. Yeah. Like that's really to me like part of the supercar thing is like accessibility. Like and to be fair, actually what's funny to me about Porsche, older Porsches were like super uncommon to be. Like
yeah.
as a kid. Like when you were
when you saw an old Targa or something.
Yeah, yeah. When I was a kid, like you saw an old 70s Porsche, you're like, oh my god, like you know, like you never see them.
Well, there weren't a whole lot of Porsches back then anyway, because
right.
I mean Porsche almost went out of business until they started cranking out
SUVs.
Yeah, the SUVs.
Right, right.
So
and
I
that's
mean
the thing.
Them. Yeah.
And that's
yeah.
the thing, it's like now
which I think that started in 05 or 06, something like that.
Yeah.
So even when the R996 came out, yeah. But
yeah.
I mean, there's just a totally different car.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. They're not, and here's the other problem I have with Porsche is like the range of the same model can go
from excessive.
It's too broad. Yeah. Like the 911 can be like, no offense, but a piece of shit to amazing.
They have like the
right?
911, the 911 Targa, the 911.
And it's confusing.
Yeah.
Carrera,
the
ass,
yeah,
there's
the 4S.
Yeah. It's like
the turbo,
know.
The turbo
like,
S.
Yeah. So like, and the problem is they're not distinguishable very easily until you get to the crazy crap.
Yeah, like the
yeah.
RS3.
Sure,
yeah.
Like,
well, back in like the 996 and even I think some of the 997, like the scoops on the side were designated as a turbo, which I mean, I guess still technically they do, but even the base models are technically turboed engines,
yeah.
not massive turbos like the actual turbo models, but yeah.
So on those, can you swap out the turbos and boost the performance way up? Like
oh, yeah.
The super expensive ones cheaply?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean on the base model ones?
Yeah.
I've never heard really looked into it.
They probably don't put as strong a bottom end on it, I would assume, right?
Yeah.
And gearbox, maybe?
And I don't know where you would fit the intercoolers in because they, you know, the bigger intercoolers for that. I don't know.
Need some 987.1 content. I love the 930 turbos. That's,
oh my god, the 930 slant nose. I would buy a Porsche for that.
My brother had an 89 930 turbo in Guards Red. It was
that's the only color to have.
It was so badass. Like, I love that story because he bought it for like $32,000 or something like that. But this was back in the day when no one wanted them because, no offense to anyone who owns a 930 turbo, they're crap. Sorry, they are. They're not a good car, but they're beautiful.
Yeah.
They're so
well, that's
looking.
The case
like,
with all old Supercars.
Like,
yeah.
I mean,
well, boy,
like,
at the old garage, they had that guard.
Yeah,
driving.
Like,
that
so short. He let me drive it, and I, like, get in there, and he's like, all right, put your foot down, but, like, be ready. And I'm like, okay, stomp. Hey, nothing's going on. Like, it takes forever for that turbo to kick on. But anyway.
That was like somebody, was that us talking about it recently with Price driving it?
Oh, yeah.
Talking about it?
Yeah, when he
was
like, racing.
Yeah, put your foot down and pray that you didn't get it a split second early and your turbo hits before you straighten it out.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. All Porsches look the same. You can't tell if the car's worth $10 or
$100,000. I wish they should have like the 9/11 to me should be like only crazy awesome, and then like they should have something else be like the lower model.
Or a Cayman or something.
Matthew, yeah. Adam, would you get a 991 GT36? So I've thought about this a lot. So the difference between a 6-speed and a PDK, I've gone back and forth about this a lot, and I think that I would get the PDK just because I track my cars. Like, I track this 911. I'm a member at a track. And as awesome as shifting gears are around town and back mountain roads and everything like that, the PDK, I mean,
yeah.
I think, unfortunately, I would do that. But if I were to just get like a regular 911, I would be a 6-speed because they still make 6-speeds, unlike Ferrari.
But if you can get it down though, so you're really good with a manual, you were a guru if you could get
left. On the track, it's so hard.
I can heel toe, but even still having to take your hand off the wheel, like going around a fast corner, it gets a little sketchy sometimes.
Yeah.
I think. But like the roads of Colorado, I was so happy I had a stick shift.
Yeah, that's the perfect time. Yeah. That's the perfect use of just like a road going fun car that you're just going to enjoy for a couple days.
Mm-hmm.
On that note, I think we're going to wrap it up. We're 6 minutes over. So thank you everyone for joining us.
Sorry if we didn't get to your questions.
Yes,
that.
Sorry.
Of course, everybody started talking about Porsches at the end of it.
I know, right? So we got a bunch.
But next week we'll be doing this.
Bring
too,
your Porsche questions. Yeah. So next week we'll try and find a way to make this work. And my family will be in town, and somehow, I don't know, be like
Worst case scenario, we'll just get to stare at my beautiful face all by myself.
That's and right.
To you for an hour. Okay.
Definitely.
We'll have the two big uglies up here.
Hey, I mean, look, Adam's in, man. He's another normal guy.
The face of normal guy.
It's kind of weird to say, but it's like, it's not my channel anymore. It's our channel.
That's pretty awesome, though.
It's kind of cool.
I have to say,
it's a lot of weight lift off my chest. Like, because it's been hard. It's been hard. I'm trying to, like, without Adam, prior to Adam, I'm trying to run normal guy. I'm trying to produce 3 videos plus a week. I'm trying to take care of everyone's orders. I'm trying to do gated 6. I'm trying to do garage clean. I'm trying to do DIY work on stuff when I can. You know, I'm trying to grow the business, add content, you know, like, add stuff to the way.
And then you still ask him, what the F are you thinking?
Yeah. And I'm dealing with a pregnant wife all at the same time. Yeah. Somewhere in there, I have to take care of the dog.
He looks well fed. I don't think
he's fine. You get your walk every morning. I walk his ass for 45 minutes every morning. Yeah.
Hey, and if y'all can do me a favor, if you have any old vintage car parts, especially Ferrari, but I'll do anything. If you have unobtainium parts, let me know, because that is my new venture, is supplying parts.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. If you didn't know, Tim is producing a part for the 348. It's the
fog light trim piece.
Yeah, which apparently is pretty common to fail on that car. And so I think you're almost in manufacturing. Are you done with manufacturing? I don't know. Anyway.
We are ready to manufacture. Pre-orders are going to be taken probably starting next week, and to determine what kind of production run we want. And we're also waiting for the patent to come in because we redesigned
it.
Redesigned the attachment method. So waiting on patent paperwork on that.
Damn,
I didn't know about this. Man. Well, we're going to try and sell it on Normal Guy too.
Yep. I was going to say, I know a place you can sell.
Exactly.
That we've already talked. So watch for that coming soon. So this trim piece, one side you can get all day long, but the passenger side is absolutely unobtainium.
Why is that?
Because the passenger side always falls off for some reason.
Oh, so the world is just completely out of it.
They totally depleted the OEM parts bin, and you literally can't get them anyplace.
Oh, wow. Raz, we're leaving. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you.
Thank you. See, I like the little guy in the rocket, by the way. This is a rocket ship. Not really. It's kind of more of like a slow crawl up a mountain.
The trudge.
The trudge up a mountain.
Tim, if you're open to other 90s cars, I'm sure I can think of parts for 3000 GT cars.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We were talking about that car before. Yeah. Those are cool cars.
Yeah, we are. We're open to any car, any make model. Obviously, we'll have to have an original piece. And even if it's broken, I can glue it together. Just something that we can get the measurements off of to rendering CAD.
Well, on that note, buy his stuff through my website as soon as it's up on there. Oh, we got another. Man, we got so many parts we have to add to the website. We have a bunch of new manufacturers. We just haven't had time. So I've showed Adam how to do adding stuff to the website. It sucks, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It takes a couple minutes.
Well, the past couple of days I've been organizing what's already on there.
Yes, so, which was needed.
Yeah.
It's going to make your experience of buying stuff on our website better.
Yeah.
But we need to add, I bet you there's at least 1,000 parts to add.
Oh, my God. At 2 minutes per entry?
Probably more than that.
Yeah. It's brutal. And I just got another manufacturer today.
Like,
oh, it's
well,
good.
I got one yesterday.
Oh, yeah. God.
Killing it.
Oh, it's so much work.
And the project.
Yeah.
When did that video drop? Saturday?
Saturday we announced the project that's in the driveway.
Dude, tune in for that. It's badass.
Dude, I want to spill the beans right now, but it's like,
no. Cut him off before he spills
the beans. We'll go out there and play with it.
Yeah.
And then the project after that is freaking... Just as
personally, I think it's even better. Yeah,
dude, they're both are y'all are gonna enjoy this.
Yeah, it's gonna be a good summer of stuff. It's gonna be a good summer. All right, we're out of here. We'll see you guys.
Good night, everybody.
Adios, everybody.
Thank you so much. We will be doing more car stuff.
It's gonna be sweet.
I am.
Cool.